Do subscribe to Ikeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Origin and Evolution of Life, and in that we are studying topic Comparative Anatomy. Now if I break that word Comparative Anatomy, it means that you are trying to compare two different taxonomical groups or two different organisms which are not completely related and trying to study their anatomy. So let's study a little bit more about comparative anatomy today. Comparative anatomy. Now, if I try to build a definition for comparative anatomy, I can say that whenever structures of different groups of organisms are studied in a comparative manner, we're trying to find out the difference, and it is observed that they exhibit some similarities or certain similar regions or characteristics that may indicate that they had a very common origin. That's comparative anatomy. Simple would be, or a simple example would be, the presence of four limbs in all vertebrate organisms. Comparative anatomy. When we talk about comparative anatomy, I could simply say that you're trying to compare two different anatomical organisms or two different taxonomical groups and trying to find out that if their anatomy is similar, they could have a similar origin in nature. Now, the definition for comparative anatomy says that whenever structure of different living organisms or different living beings are analyzed or they are studied in a comparative way or in a comparative spirit, it is observed that these organisms or this living species may exhibit or show certain similarities that might indicate that they belong to certain common origin. For example, the presence of four limbs in most of the vertebrates like birds, horses, seal, man, etc. Now, all the four limbs in all these vertebrates have different functions. Also, they look quite different in all of them. Though all the vertebrates that possess or have four limbs may look different, or they could simply have different functions in man, seal, or different animals, but still they could be called as homologous organs since they had a common origin. Also, they were built on the same pentadactyl plane. Might they have different modifications? For example, in man, the forelimbs or legs are modified for running, walking. In birds, the forelimbs were modified for some other function. In seals or whales, the forelimbs were modified or stretched to certain levels for movement in water. And they performed different functions. Still, they had this common origin that they were all associated to movement in some or other form. Now also, these forelimbs had certain other similarities in the terms of arrangement or in the terms of this presence of tissues or cells. For example, the arrangement of bones, if we talk about the arrangement of blood vessels, or the nerves which try to possess the impulse or signals throughout them by connecting your brain as well as the motor neuron or effector neurons. Now, these bones or the bones present in their forelimbs were derived or maybe obtained from same part of the body, which was quite a similarity. So students, in this part of the chapter, what we did study was about comparative anatomy and how this comparative anatomy implies in the case of forelimbs in different vertebrates. I hope students, we all are very clear with this concept. Thank you.